Here's a clinical case study. It's a laboratory medicine diagnostic dilemma. It's a real dilemma for anybody who works critical access emergency medicine. How would you have handled this? What would you have done? So bottom line is I come into a night shift. I relieve the doc who's on during the day, and at night it's run by myself. He signs out two patients to me. Both of them are hyperglycemic, and I'm waiting on labs. Fine. Whenever I get signed out, I always go gestalt the patients. I read their note, I look at their vital signs, and I go examine the patient myself. The one young lady was young 20s, and she said she ran out of her insulin and she had high reading at home, therefore she's in. No real symptoms. So I talked to her a little bit, and she looks very stable to me. Vital signs look stable. Fine. So I start taking care of other patients, and at one point I went in and got a little more history from this patient, and she was interesting in a sense that she told me she lost about 15 pounds in a month. And I said, well, how did you do that? She goes, oh, and she seemed evasive. I really thought she was a bulimic or an anorexic. I thought she was somehow intentionally losing weight. Clearly, that could be problematic as a diabetic. But I didn't go into any more detail than leaving going, I think she lost a lot of weight in a way that wasn't healthy. Well, all of a sudden, I get called back in the room as her mom's now in the room. And I went back in to have another dialogue. And I said, well, were you drinking alcohol last night? The next thing you know, this young girl starts yelling at her mom. Mom, shut up. Half up, and she's screaming at her mom, and I go, okay, clearly there's some psychosocial issues here. And at one point, I came back in the room because she became very theatrical, yelling and screaming about it. I'm going, am I missing something here? So bottom line is I have a young lady who comes in with a chief complaint of hyperglycemia. I'm concerned about weight loss in an unhealthy fashion. She was drinking the night before, and somehow there's some negative communications with her mom, some psychosocial issue. And then this theatrical component. So I don't know if there's an anxiety component. Well, bottom line is, as her labs come back, her labs were very interesting. Initially, her blood sugar was in the low 300 range. Not really DK range, but it's possible. Her bicarbonate chemistry was less than 5. Interestingly, her potassium was very low at 2.1. Her calcium was very low at like 3.4. She was significantly anemic at 7 and 21. Now, when I look back at labs from past visits about 3 months ago, her calcium, her H&H, and her potassium were normal. She was so anemic that I went and did a rectal exam, and that was OB negative. I did a blood gas on her, and she was indeed acidic at 7.10. And her bicarb was, at least it was low on her chemistry. Her carbon dioxide was low as well. So everything about her lab screams a metabolic acidosis. But the problem is, I mean, anytime I've seen DKA, they're always hyperkalemic, and she's hypokalemic. So guys, here's my clinical dilemma. What would you do here? So I'm going, wait a second, is this that eating disorder, some kind of cross metabolic, a mixed acid-base disorder? So this is a scenario that I'd like you to think about. What would you do at this point right now with that potassium that low? What would you do? What would you be thinking? And I'd like to tell you the conclusion in 3 days. For anybody who likes, shares, or comments on this video, I'll make sure you get the solution, because this was a real shocker to me.